Yo, what is up guys, welcome to another video. So in today's video I'm gonna be giving away this super clean Windows intro which you can use in your Fortnite montages for completely free. And to use this intro you will need Premiere Pro, and also you will need Photoshop for this, just because to make that like graphics and stuff I used Photoshop. So if you want to customize that stuff you will need Photoshop for this. But yeah, if you don't have Photoshop or Premiere Pro you can just DM me on Discord and I will just make that intro with your logo and all the text you need. I will just make it for you for a very little price, like $1 or $2 will do. But if you don't like to pay, that's completely fine, I'll just make it for free. But if you can pay for me, that will be really appreciated. And yeah, without any further ado, let's start the video. Alrighty, so go ahead and click the download link and go ahead and unlock the download link, and then it'll lead you to a Google Drive link or a mega file. Just download that, so and it'll download as a zip folder, and then just extract that zip folder using WinRAR or 7-zip. And after you extract the zip file you will see this folder right here. Just open up the folder and you'll see all these files. So here's the font, just double click on the zip and just select all these files, put it to the folder and install the font. So after that, here's the icons and here are some wallpapers and these are some sound effects, and this is some more wallpapers which you can use, and here's the some like assets which I use to make the intro. And yeah, so here are some PSD files. So as I told you before, you will need Photoshop for this. So these are the PSD files, and then I will add the Premiere Pro project file later on. So yeah, so just double click on the Premiere Pro project file and it'll open up Premiere Pro right here. So as you open up the project for the first time, it'll say like media offline or something like that. So to fix that, all you want to do is just right click on any of these like layers or like these files. So right click and you're gonna click on link media, and it'll open up a window like file explorer or something like that, and then just lead to the location where you guys download the zip file and extract, where you guys download the file. And then in the files just find where is that this file. So it says subscribe animation, and in this folder just find where is that file is. So it's right here, just select that and click on OK or something like that, and then it'll be linked and automatically all the other like files will be linked. So yeah, and then let's see how to customize these things. So to customize this little login screen, all you want to do is you want to open up the login screen nested sequence right here, and here you will see all the layers. So to change the name, you want to select the text layer right here, you want to select the go to effects controls and select this, and then just double click on this text and just type what you like to type. So like you can just type your name just like that, and yeah, that's how you can customize the text like the name. And to customize the logo, like you will need to customize the logo manually. That's the only thing that you need to do manually. So to do that, just put your logo and then just resize it and just position your logo to this where my logo is right here. Just position your logo right there. And after you've done that, all you want to do is you want to go to this keyframe right here, you want to copy this. So select them, right click, and you want to click on copy and then just paste it to your logo, and also copy these two effects and right click, click copy and just paste it to your logo, and then it'll be updated on this screen. And also if you want to change the wallpaper, just put your wallpaper right here and you will be done. So then moving on to the desktop, there's actually nothing to change other than the wallpaper. So open up the desktop nested sequence and double click on desktop wallpaper, and then you can just put your wallpaper right here. If you have like a custom wallpaper or something like that, you can just put it right here and it'll be updated on this sequence. And then so for the Google interface thing, as you can see in this I have my logo right here. So to fix that, just go to google.com and screenshot of your interface with your logo and stuff, and then just open up the Google nested sequence, open up the Google interface, and then just put your logo like the screenshot right here. And then to change the like the title, just double click on text Google nested sequence and just double click on the layer and just type what you like to type, just like that, like over edit montage, you can just type what you like to type and it will be updated right here. So then obviously you will need to change this little cursor thing. So just select the cursor and change the position where you want the cursor to be. So you can just, you know, like, you can change the position just like that. And yeah, after that, to change this, just open up the Google search result, that nested sequence. And to change this, all you want to do is, like before, just select this, double click right here, and then just type what you like to type, like Rambo edits montage or something like that. You can just type what you like to type. And yeah, it applies the same thing for the other text. So just type what you like to type. And if the text is look something like this, if it is not aligned, all you want to do is you want to get the move tool and select the preview, and you want to click on control and this icon. I will put that on the screen right now. And then just select the layer and then just reposition that right here, just like that, and it'll be aligned. And yeah, you can just change that just like that. After that, to change the YouTube interface kind of thing, all you want to do is, now you will need Photoshop. So you will need Photoshop only for this part. So just open up the file which says YouTube interface, just double click on that and it'll open up Photoshop right here. So if you don't have Photoshop, just install it and just open up the PSD file. And after you open up the PSD file, it looks something like this. So to change all this up, all you want to do is double click on the title right here and then just type what you like to type, just like that, like maxi overedit. You can just type what you like to type and boom, now you have that updated. And to change the views, you can just zoom in, double click right here. Can just type 100k, like that never happens, but you can type whatever the views you want to have. So yeah, and then you can change the date. So just double click right here. So I create this in August 31st, but today is like September 7th, like that's a long time, bro. So just select this, type September, and you can just type the date like 7, just like that. And yeah, to change the name, just double click right here, just type the name of your channel and of course the subscribers. So just double click right here, just select this and just type the subscribers, like 10k someday, I don't know. Yeah, so then to change the logo, just put your logo and reposition your logo to this position right here, and of course scale your logo down. And open up the logo group and make sure to put your logo on top of this ellipse thing, and then right click on your logo and make a clipping mask, and it'll just look something like this. So after that, to change the likes and dislikes, all you want to do is double click right here and just type whatever the likes you want, like 1k, something like that. And you can just customize all this up just like that. And so after you done that, all you want to do is you're gonna click file and click save. So then just close this up and then just select the PSD file and then just put this to your project, and it'll open up a box something like this. All you want to do is you're gonna click on this and make sure that is in merge all layers and click OK. And then just put your and then open up the nested sequence and then put your that image right here, okay, and you will be done. So after you've done that, all you want to do is then just put your montage underneath of this file, and also make sure to copy this ultra key effect. So right click and copy that and then just paste it to your interface which you customized, and then just paste that and you will be done. And then all you want to do is you want to cut your clip on this frame. It is like four seconds and three frames. You want to cut your montage right there and copy the other part and go to this main sequence and then just paste it where, like, so after this has been scaled up, just paste it right there and you'll be done. And yeah guys, that's pretty much it for the video, and if you need any help, be sure to join my Discord server. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll catch you guys on my next video. Peace.